Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brandon Wynn. This is my brother, Brian Wynn, and we are going to be writing down his character class features in the player handbook. Not the player handbook, but Roll20, basically all the stuff that he's going to need. Excuse me. This is for his Jazalt barbarian fighter named Aether, and he is writing down the barbarian stats right now. I've already kind of explained it to him. I'm going to explain it to you guys. Basically, what I'm making him do is go from level 1 and on both classes on a separate sheet of paper, writing down its level 1's abilities, skipping a line and starting over for the next ability. And I'm going to show you once it's done. Make sure to write to where you're able to read it, all right? Or someone else, because someone else might need to read it also, depending on DM. But a very big thing with this is making sure that the point is driven across. And since this is my first time, my brother's playing a barbarian, I want him to be able to read through his entire thing without having to pull out a phone or anything and just read it straight from his paper. And it's going to be a lot of paper, but he's going to be able to see it and read it and learn throughout the thing and eventually get the understandings of a barbarian by itself. And as you can see on this one, I wrote down fighter, level 1, and pardon for my terrible handwriting, but he's going to basically go through the level 1 stuff all the way down until he's done. We do have extra paper just in case we need it. I don't think that we will, but I know we have a page for feats because we're starting off at level 1 with 1 feat. So we're going to have a lot of stuff for him just to make sure that he has it. And I know that we did a video, but this is coming out, it's going to be coming out later, on how we make our characters. My brother already had a player character idea. We came up with his race. He wanted to be an elf, a wood elf specifically, and he already had class in mind, so he kind of, didn't you base it off a character from Seven Deadly Sins?
It's not from Seven Deadly Sins.
Okay. Never mind. I thought he based his character off of someone from Seven Deadly Sins. Just the ability, like his strength and prowess. But I was wrong. I thought that. But didn't the name come from Seven Deadly Sins then?
No.
No? Okay. I thought it did. I thought Seven Deadly Sins was in there somewhere.
No.
But I coached him a little bit into helping him get this. But it's very important that he's writing everything that there is so he can actually genuinely understand it, because he has played a wizard before, he's played a fighter, but he's never played a barbarian, but he's only played these with like a few games every once in a while. So he's kind of a new player. He hasn't played a lot. So I'm trying to get it to where he understands things. He doesn't have to eventually reference notes as often. Because, I mean, there are times where I have to reference notes. I've only played the Barbarian like once or twice, so I know I haven't learned everything, but I'm excited for this. I'm happy that we're going to be able to record something, and once he's done writing for the Rage, I'm going to show you guys what's all up, and I'm actually proud that he's doing a lot more than what he is, but I'm going to explain the ability to him, just go until he finishes the barbarian, depending on how long the video has been recording. We might do the fighter, but I'm basically going to be coaching, talking it when needed and stuff like that. How much more do you have, Dino? You got a good bit. Oop. A big thing is that if he could screenshot it and make sure he could keep it in a specific folder for it to be done, it'd be different, but I know that writing it down would help it stick, so that's a very big thing. If you are an experienced player and you want a screenshot on your phone or print it out, that's one thing. I would like to be able to do printouts, but we don't have a printer, we don't have the ability to do it. But yeah, sorry, I just got a text message. And I am trying to get him to learn from writing. And what's one thing so far? Finish that sentence before I ask you a question. Did you finish the sentence already? No, finish the sentence. It's before I ask you the question. It's for a reason. All right. Without looking at your page and without something that you just wrote, what is one thing that you've learned about the Barbarian's Rage so far? You have not been paying attention to this.
No, I was just writing.
Pay attention while you're reading, because this is your ability. This is
with primal ferocity.
You just looked at it, but that doesn't matter. That's fluff text. That is flavor text. A big thing with rage, I can tell you right now, I don't know if you've gotten into it yet, but you have advantage on strength checks. I'm not sure about dexterity checks. And you have damage resistances to slashing, bludgeoning, and piercing damage. Have you gotten that far so far?
I was about to do that next.
Okay, but you have strength checks right there.
Mm-hmm.
Pay attention while you're reading also, okay? You're writing it down, but you have to pay attention also, okay? You have to soak up what you're writing. Okay?
I feel like it's going over.
D&D is a learning process, okay, Thorn? It's like how, like, you were playing the Warlock? No, you were playing the Orc Wizard, and you kept casting only Magic Missile, and if you ever cast something else, you kept using the D4, but we had to teach you that the D4 is not all the die.
When you said D4, you wrote D4. +2. It's supposed to be +2, but I put +4.
It's fine, just put +2. It's fine. But. Oh, you're getting called. Go ahead. I'm going to talk to the camera. So my brother's being called right now. And a very big thing while making a character is making sure that you have the ability stuff on hand. Now, he hasn't finished it, but I know that it's going to take time to look up your ability stats. Not everyone's going to know your ability stats. There's going to be arguments on ability ability feats and your character feats. It's going to be annoying. Class feats. Are you good? Is that your clothes?
Yes.
Okay.
And I'll have to go with Dad.
To where?
Go get milk.
Okay.
So
I got to talk anyways, but
finish this later.
Yeah, we're going to finish this at a later point, record it later, but a very big thing is making sure that you understand your character class, as I was trying to get him to understand, and trying to understand without having to write it down. That is a very big thing, like memorizing it. Memory in D&D is a very big thing. That's why if you watch other characters, or at least if you watch our guys, like when we play D&D at my group, we don't have a lot of the stuff. We'll have like the spells like written down because we don't know all the spells unless we're very, very, very well known and versed in them. I'm not. I play more of a martial class. You're stepping on your character sheet. But I know for a fact that if you ask me about the Blood Hunter, the modern one I can't, but if you ask me about some of the other stuff, like the older edition or older variants of the Blood Hunter, I could tell you a lot about it. Right now, I can't tell you a whole lot about the Profane Soul. I don't like the Profane Soul. The Ghost Slayer is my favorite class. Screw you, Thorn. And that scared the fuck out of me. I'm not even gonna lie. I thought the power went out. And what's the last one? Order of the Mutant. That's what it is. And the Order of the Mutant is the class that I'm currently playing. That one got really confusing for me. It didn't really seem very important. And Profane Soul was just a whole bunch of clusterfuck of issues. And I played the Blood Hunter so much in the older editions of the Blood Hunter that it got ingrained in me. Now, I'm not saying that you have to play the same character, the same class, or anything like that multiple times until you get it. I'm just saying try to stick with it until it becomes something. Because, or at least while you're playing it, learn some of the abilities. Like, the Barbarian is known for Rage. So, if there's one thing that you should know about the Barbarian, it has resistance to bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing. And depending on the archetype, I think it is, it depends on the abilities they're on. Like the bear, I think you get resistance to psychic damage. I think there's other ones where you get resistance to fire and stuff like that. Like, there's one where you basically get resistance to everything. It's really kind of cool. Like, right now, for my Blood Hunter, Lucarius, I have one that boosts my wisdom stat by +2, if I'm correct. So it busts it up to a 17. And I have one that, I have three that do some really cool things. I have one that makes it, I have resistance to bludgeoning, but I have vulnerability to slashing. One that, I think it's slashing, it might be piercing. But basically, it just kind of correlates with it. The slashing one is piercing, the piercing one is bludgeoning. Bludgeoning one is slashing, if I'm correct. So that's basically what it is. It's resistance, then vulnerability. And I took all of those because I remember that was a very big thing. I wanted my character to have resistance to something other than fire. And I was like, I'll take this potion and it'll help me. I remember in older editions, you would negate the bad side effect of a potion, of one of the Order of the Mutant, mutagens is what they're called. And they took that out because it was just not balanced correctly. And that is a very big thing to know, even though I didn't play it until until this character, it still is useful to know on hand in case someone else wants to play it. Like, if you're not doing anything and you want to study up on D&D stuff, definitely study up on the classes. That is a huge thing. It's a lot of info. There's a lot of archetypes, but it's worth it. Like, people that you should definitely go to, AJ Pickett, Jordan, it's Jorfton, but the PH is silent. They both have, I think Jordan has really good ones. I don't watch Jordan a lot, but I think he has some character class videos. DM Shower Thoughts, he has a couple things of why the classes are important. I haven't watched them yet, but I'm going to assume that they involve some of the stats and characteristics of them. I would say give him a try. Nerdarchy, if I'm correct, has some character stuff on theirs. So definitely look around for some stuff. We went in depth on the Blood Hunter because the Blood Hunter was my favorite class and why we didn't like them at the time. And we got to do an up-to-date version of that because it kind of got thrown out of the park when they did a new one. But it kind of holds up a little bit for the older editions. But we wanted to do the Cleric next. There's a shit ton of stuff with the Cleric. Like, a lot. So, that one's going to take us a long time just to go through. And you can only imagine having us remember that. Like, the Cleric, I'm playing a Blood Hunter Cleric. All I remember is that I have Healing Word. I have Turn Undead, which undead have to make a wisdom saving throw of a certain DC to, or be turned away from me and basically be frightened of me. It's wild as fuck. I like Turn Undead. And I have, that's all I can remember. I know we're like level 4, but that's like the best I can remember at the current moment. I haven't looked at my character sheet in a while. Obviously, I'm failing at my own aspect of learning stuff. I need to remember what cleric stuff. I do have the Blood Domain, which is newer. It's in the Tal'Dorei setting, if I'm correct. So I gotta read that, but Ed has a Tal'Dorei setting. And God, I wish he was here. We could talk about that on its own. But I think I should definitely be reading up on the cleric stuff more. I'm probably gonna end up watching AJ Pickett's video on the cleric Jordans if he has one. And I think it'd be really cool to do that. If you guys aren't subscribed to them, definitely go subscribe to all the guys that I said. They are very good D&D I'm not going to call them nerds, but they're definitely gurus in their own respect. I know Matt Coville has a very good DM type of setting on things. So if you're trying to be a DM, definitely go check him out. But I can't stress enough how learning your character class really helps, because there's nothing like someone telling you how to play your character and you don't know, versus knowing how to play your character and someone just telling you, hey, you're doing it wrong, and you can show them through experience or through your own text, hey, you're wrong, this is bullshit. Because I even get, from time to time, end up getting bullshit called on me on the Blood Hunter, and Ed will read up on it while I'm sitting there trying to read up on it, and then I'll be wrong. And I play the class most. So it really does take like time to do stuff like that, but you should do it anyways. It's more important to be correct and make sure that you're playing the game correctly than it is to be thinking you're correct and end up being an ass and look like an idiot in front of everyone. So definitely try to learn about stuff like that, because you don't want to be playing it wrong and then feel like an idiot. I've been there. Trust me, it's not fun. It's all fun and games until you're made a fool. So that's a very big thing. But I've been kind of rambling on, saying the same things over and over. So thank you guys for watching. Please leave a like and subscribe. I'm going to probably put it like in this direction because I have a new video editing thing. But I really do hope you guys... Actually, it's probably going to already be up there, because I don't know if I can just push it here and have it pop up or not, because I don't know the video editing thing on the iPhone very well. So pardon my issues with it, but at some point I'm going to have some sort of weird fade thing, if I have a fade thing. Excuse me, goddamn. And there's going to be some weird ending before I turn off this phone. And there's going to be a bit that says something about what this video is about. But thank you guys for watching. I am kind of excited to be able to edit these videos a little bit better than what they were. I'm going to definitely have, in the end of this video, my Instagram name for the channel. So you guys can actually have a physical representation that you can read of what it is. So you have something on that. But thank you guys. I know I said it already, but please leave a like and subscribe. Comment down below anything that we can fix. Please tell me about last video that I uploaded, the homebrew ideas. Tell me if you enjoyed like the little thing in the top above Ed's head. I know I found that funny while putting it up there. And try to help me out. Suggest some video editing software that's for free on the iPhone that I could use to possibly do some stuff. I know I'm using Splice right now, but I bought the Pro Edition because it wouldn't let me save the edited stuff to my phone that I needed to download. So I kind of did that, which is kind of a no-no on my own aspect, and it kind of pisses me off that I had to do that. But hey, I know that that was the first thing I found that Ed said he liked, so I'm trying my best here. But yeah, definitely let me know how you like these new kind of video things. But anyway... thank you guys. I really do appreciate it. And just bear with me as I'm going through these new video techniques. So see ya.